I'll start with Leanne, if that's all right. How's this week been?
Yeah, really good. Obviously, after the result on Sunday, it was a nice confidence boost for everyone just to continue in that good form that we've been in. So we've again had another really good training week, and we're ready and prepared for the game on Sunday now.
Yeah, how's the squad looking?
Yeah, good. The new players that have come in are settling really well. We've also been able to introduce a couple of the players that have been rehabbing back into some of the team functions this week. So it's every single day we're growing in strength. So it's nice to see them coming back in, but also nice to see Carly and Wilma settling in as well.
Yeah, well, I was going to ask you about the new signings. I mean, what was it that kind of drew you to them? What do you think they're going to bring to the squad?
I think they both have attributes that really suit the way that we want to play. So they both like to play attacking, fast football. They both find spaces in midfield, and can get turned, and they're technically gifted that they can either finish themselves or they're able to go and assist their teammates with goals. So obviously, first and foremost, that was the thing that attracted us to them, and then on meeting them, obviously their characters as well. I think we've brought in two players that can really add to the squad, both on and off the pitch.
Yeah, and this weekend's opponents, Hibs, they're obviously on a great run recently. You've got a really good league record against them, but how tough do you think this test is going to be on Sunday?
It'll be a huge test for us, because games against Hibs, as you say, are always tough. They're probably considered our rivals over the years in terms of us both fighting it out for the trophies that were on offer. So I think that rivalry is still there. I think they still have a fantastic team. And then Grant, they've got a manager that really has a defined style of play, so he's got them playing really well now. He's had that time since coming back in, and I think, yeah, it will be a big test for us on Sunday, but again, we're in a good run of form ourselves and riding high with the confidence as well.
Yeah, and then just kind of looking ahead to after the Cup, you've got a slightly easier league run heading into the split. What's that like, kind of, in terms of getting the mentality right and not letting, I suppose, maybe a bit of complacency set in when you get the tough tests out of the way and maybe have a slightly easier few games?
I think it's a bit disrespectful to say that it's going to be easier games. I think the teams in this league are strengthening every minute. You can see that the work that's going on off the field as well with all of the clubs, they're really trying to improve their squads and make the games as competitive as possible. So we've had difficult games, particularly against Montrose this season already, so we won't be taking anything for granted in terms of league positions, and we'll prepare exactly as we do for any game that we have, and that's given 100% respect to our opponents and preparing properly for the game.
Brilliant, thank you. And just moving on to Michaela now, if that's all right. You were back in the starting lineup against Celtic. What was that like for you on a personal level?
Yeah, it was obviously really exciting for me. I think the injury at the back end of last year was a frustrating kind of time, as is any injury for any player. So yeah, I've just been working daily with everyone here to get back, so I can help the team and do my job when asked of.
Yeah, and obviously, you know, it's a cup game, another really important game. Just like the league is really important, but what's the kind of, just how important is it for you guys to stay in this cup and keep challenging on all fronts?
Yeah, I think Glasgow City obviously has a rich history in every competition, so we want to be competing right until till the very end, and currently we're still in this cup and doing well in the league, and we just want to carry the momentum that we've had over past weeks into this one, and that's what we've been focusing on this week, and we'll take each game as it comes.
Cool, good, thanks. Just a quick one, does this cup competition have extra significance for you, just in the fact that you guys haven't won it for a couple of seasons?
No, like Michaela's saying, every competition that we take part in, we want to be right in it up until the end. We want to be competing for the silverware. So as a player here, it was always a competition that I enjoyed winning and competing in. And the players are no different now. So anytime they take to the pitch, whether it be in the league or in any of the cups, they want to go and win, and they want to represent themselves and the club to the best of their abilities.
How do you feel it's different, like, from a league game? Do you think, obviously, it's a be all and end all in a cup tie?
Well, that's just it. You either win or you're out. So that's obviously the focus in terms of getting the result that you need. There's not really any second chances in a cup competition. So it's all about being 100% focused and prepared. And I think we've done a good job of that this week so far.
Also, too, I would imagine if you do go on and progress, it just sustains the momentum that you've started to build, Julie, since before Christmas.
Yeah, of course. And I think it has been important for us. I think that the confidence has been building with each result, but that comes from the players performing on the pitch as well. So it's a credit to them that they've come in and they've worked really hard to turn our form around, and they're able to put us on this good run that we're on at this moment in time. So, as I said, we've had a good week in training, and hopefully that'll reflect our performance again on Sunday.
Mentally, how much does the squad take out on Sunday's result?
Yeah, probably a lot. Recent performances against Celtic and Rangers haven't brought the results we feel that sometimes we have deserved. So I think to put on that performance and to get, for me, a deserved 3 points on Sunday is a big boost for everyone. And the mood's been good this week on the back of that result. So we're hoping that can continue into the cup on Sunday.
Any two new arrivals set to start or set to figure in at all on Sunday?
They'll both be in the squad, yeah, so just like everybody else, they're in contention to start. So we just need to evaluate where they're at in terms of minutes that they'll be available for. But yeah, they're both fit and they will be available.
Thanks, Leanne. Michaela, you set up Fiona for the goal on Sunday, what, within 10 seconds or something? Well, goal was 15, so 10 seconds, did she mean it?
Yeah, I mean, she's alluded to that it was a cross, but at the end of the day, a ball in the back of the net is what matters most, and so, yeah, it's a goal counted.
How frustrating was it for you to be out when the team maybe weren't performing as well as you could have at times?
I think for me, the frustration was more internally. We have a big squad for a reason, and we know any player that takes that pitch, the starting 11, can do a job for us and will give their all. So for me, it was more just the internal battle of my day-to-day rehab and getting back to full fitness.
And you feel 100% now, I take it?
Yeah, I feel really good. I think just building up minutes and hopeful weeks will be good for me. But yeah, the time in training over the past few weeks has done me good since Christmas.
Just before both of you go, can I ask each of you what your favourite cup memory is?
For me, it needs to be, I think it was the 2019 final when Claire Shine scored the winner at Tynecastle. So it was a special one for me. It was the last one that I won as a player. And yeah, you don't really get much better feeling than those last minute goals in a really tight game. So that was probably the most special one for me.
Well, obviously last year didn't go as well for us, but I've heard a lot about that memory that Leanne's talking about, so hopefully we can continue that this year.
Thanks,